here's an interesting piece of news from New York. Diners there could soon see a COVID-19 surcharge on their bills to help cover COVID-19 costs incurred by the restaurant. The so-called COVID-19 recovery charge could be as much as 10% of the total bill. Now, here at home, how are our own restaurants doing 6 months into the pandemic? We're speaking with Gregorio, president and CEO of Shakey's, the country's largest casual dining and restaurant brand. Hi, Vic. Good morning. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Michelle. Thank you for having me in your program.
Okay, so tell us about how you've been trying to stay afloat in these really uncertain times. And what are your estimates for the rest of the year now that we're seeing slow reopening?
To be very frank, Michelle, everything remains to be very fluid. And it's kind of hard to predict how the balance of the year would go. Mm-hmm. But with the implementation of the GCQ in NCR lately, there definitely are signs of improvement, and we are kind of hopeful. To date, we're looking at just focusing on off-premise business because the dine-in business has really gone down. Safety remains a major concern. So the whole group is adapting to the changes and the consumers, and we're trying our best to navigate through this one.
Mm-hmm. And by off-premise, you mean delivery services, correct?
Yes, delivery and carryout. We are still grateful that Shakey's having pizza as a core product is very strong in delivery and off-premise business, even before COVID. And we were able to invest heavily in our delivery platforms, our online digital platforms. And we have established strong business partnerships with our aggregators, partners. And this has worked very well for us during this crisis.
Mm-hmm. Vic, I'm very curious. When you say that delivery and takeout were already big parts of the business even before COVID, how big? Would you say they contribute like 50% of total revenue?
We were doing about 30 to 40% of our revenues and sales were off-premise before COVID. Mm-hmm. Majority of the business was still dine-in. Mm-hmm. We're known for our great service, our beautiful stores. But things have changed, obviously, because of the crisis. And we have very strong delivery platforms to our very famous delivery hotline, mm-hmm. 777. And we've had our own delivery apps and websites way before. Mm-hmm. And like I said, this has contributed very strongly to our ability to navigate through this crisis. Mm-hmm.
Vic, I know aside from delivery, you've also started to sell frozen mojos in groceries. Some of your branches have al fresco dining options. But the group itself, you recently brought in a new brand, Singapore's R&B milk tea brand. Are there other acquisitions on the horizon as you try to find your footing during this time?
Thank you for mentioning the move on R&B. Mm-hmm. It is really more of an opportunistic move. We saw very strong synergy with this brand and their products with our delivery business and off-premise business. That kind of product, milk tea, has been a very popular and staple take-home and delivery product. Mm-hmm. So we feel it's perfect for our pizzas and our delivery and take-home business. Down the road, we don't know what opportunities will come up, but we believe within this crisis and even beyond, we're hopeful that opportunities will come. Mm-hmm. But nothing concrete at the moment.
Mm-hmm. And of course, one of the big issues facing restaurants now would be the amount of opening that's allowed. We're currently at 50%. I imagine it's hard for the industry to survive at those types of levels.
It is difficult. The reason many of the industry players are really getting hit hard is most of the restaurant players and the businesses have relied heavily on delivery. And with the limitations that has been imposed for safety reasons, you can imagine it's a sudden downturn and a drastic decrease in sales. Mm-hmm. Not enough to cover most of the cost and overhead. We have been trying to adapt to the situation by, like you mentioned, offering contactless solutions. Mm-hmm. We wanted to offer dine-in al fresco. We have our own version of delivery, which is our park and order. Mm-hmm. So these are some of the initiatives that we have implemented, and we were very very happy with the outcome. We get a lot of feedback from our guests saying it's well timed and they really feel safe about this. So it's all about adapting to the very fast changing situation.
There's been a lot of concerns, Vic, you know, that people wouldn't want to be going back to eating inside restaurants until a vaccine is actually out. Is there early data that you're seeing, maybe from your intelligence group or from, you know, survey groups that do the survey, that on, you know, is there data that show or talk about the demand and how quickly consumers may return?
Definitely, consumers are wary and very conscious about safety, and they want to feel, they want to know, and they want to see that the restaurants are safe to dine in. It will just change, and they will only feel more secure when the vaccine becomes readily available. But in general, I think Filipinos would still eat out eventually, and even as the government has loosened the rules and allowed 50% capacity, we already are seeing some good signs. Slowly but surely, the dine-in sales recovery has been moving in the right direction. And barring any shift to more stricter quarantine rules, we think it will inch up and improve. And but it will take some more time before it goes back to pre-COVID levels.
And I know that you guys also own the rights here in Asia, except Malaysia and Japan, as well as in China, the Middle East, and Australia. What are the trends that you're seeing there in those territories?
You're correct. Our group owns the Shakey's brand in half the globe, basically. And everybody got hit. This is a global pandemic, and all the different markets have experienced a severe degree of business reduction. We have a few stores in the Middle East. They're still up. They're also trying to navigate and survive this crisis. We're helping them in any way we can. But like us, they feel they just have to hold on and persevere until things get better.
And how much relief, Vic, have you gotten or are you getting from the government pandemic relief measures? For example, Bayanihan 1, Bayanihan 2. And what would you say, what are the other things that the industry will need to cope?
We don't have an exact figure, like a direct aid from the local and national government. But we are very thankful that they have initiated the Bayanihan 1 and Bayanihan 2 programs. They have supported the industry in terms of assisting us in dealing with our rental issues and loan payments. And they're really a big thing for us. Cash is a major problem for most of the players. So we don't have direct aid, but we keep close coordination with them, with all the health agencies and local governments, so that we can adapt and continue our business in a safe way. And we intend to cooperate with them as much as we can.
You mentioned stores. Great to hear that the government's able to help you, you know, negotiate better terms with your landlord. You currently have 279 stores. Are you looking at the possibility of closing some of them for good?
We continue to study store per store. We're very glad majority of our stores are up. If I'm not mistaken, just only about a dozen are still closed temporarily. Well, we want to open them as soon as possible, but we just have to be very sure everything is safe, and it's also very you know, realistic and practical to open those stores.
No plans of closing some of them down permanently?
It will be just a handful from what we see now, by my estimates, a dozen stores maybe. But again, too early to tell. We feel we've been able to navigate this crisis relatively better because of the inherent strengths of our business model and our brand strength. But we always plan for the worst and hope and prepare for better times.
But even during the worst of times, I know that Shakey's has not really stopped, you know, providing assistance to those who need it. Can you talk to us about some of your efforts for the community as you give back to society?
Oh yes, definitely. We are working closely with our sister company, the Century Pacific Group. And one of the key programs would be helping and providing meals for the frontliners. To date, a total of about 260,000 meals have been distributed to different hospitals to support them. And because for us, they are really the new heroes. And we work again with the government to make sure all the safety protocols are not just met, we even want to exceed them. And even during this crisis, we continue to be mindful of our sustainability programs. We continue to be with our program of achieving plastic neutrality. So we've taken away straws several months back. So we continued on these programs because we feel they are important. And crisis or no crisis, they are ongoing.
Okay. On that note, thank you very much, Vic, for joining us this morning.
Thank you.